Masahiro Tanaka. He was simply superb in the playoffs last year, but you forget he had a rough regular season. He had a terrible May, and his regular season was up and down. So I'm curious, you know, Dontrelle, his importance to the Yankees. We keep talking about how great their lineup is. What about Tanaka?
Well, he's the veteran behind Severino to take pressure off that. And in this rotation, everyone's been hurt. So health is wealth in that rotation. I think that's the Achilles heel of this ball club, especially if they hurt themselves. Now, he needs to learn to be able to live low and live long, especially with that slip finger. He did a great job of changing eye level today. But the injuries could take a toll, and now you don't want him to have a stress fracture or anything like that on his elbow because he's had some miscues on that elbow. So that's a worry. But for me, I want to see him get early contact, get early out so he can go deeper in the ball game and take less of strain off his elbow.
And I think he needs to be the guy we saw at the end of the second half of the Yankees last year and into the playoff. He was dominant. He had life on his fastball. The key with him is his velocity on his fastball. If he's throwing mid-90s, 92, 93, 94,
He's gonna
get a lot of outs because this guy knows how to pitch. Definition of professional big league pitcher.
Yeah, I would agree with you on that. Six innings today, 8 strikeouts, only 1 run allowed. You know, just a sidebar. You know, Blue Jays, to me, they're a team that can go either way. But you forget how good Aaron Sanchez is trained watching him pitch tonight. I know he gave it up there, you know, had to leave the game, but his stuff is wicked.
You want to see the reps from him. He's gone through some injuries, but again, when you see the natural ability, you saw the sinker at 95 to 96 down in the zone. He has that whooper-dooper,
yes,
that wipeout slider too. I love this tempo, but he ran out of gas. But as he gets stronger and gets older, he'll start to learn how to pitch to contact. And like I said, for Tanaka, get early contact and get outs. I think a lot of pitchers now, they want to strike everybody out. But the pitch count starts to rise, and you see a lot of guys' pitch counts get to 100 early in the ball game. They need to learn how to start a game if they want to finish the game.
Well, they've groomed this guy to be their ace. The key for him is strike one. When he's ahead of the count, he's vicious. You saw that sinker down and then plowing in the right-handers. He can control a ball game, but he's got to work ahead in the count.
One last note, there is some concern for the Blue Jays. Josh Donaldson DHing today. He had some really weird throwing issues considering he's an excellent defensive player. They're calling it a dead arm, but that would concern me if I'm the Blue Jays. He's at DH, and we'll see. I don't like the we'll see.
Not at all. That concerns his agent more. He's a free agent this year.
I would agree. He's just too good. We've got to see him play.
You might want to start talking about negotiating
great
again.
Player. Yeah, that's right.
Right about now. So I think we all assume the Dodgers are the favorite. They went to the World Series. But, Frank, in the NL West, who is the number one challenger to L.A.?
I've been saying it all offseason. To acquire Longoria and McCutcheon to a team that's accustomed to winning, the only problem you've had over the last 5 years in my eyes has been offense. Now you bring in two valuable, productive pieces that are used to hitting all year long, having to carry the ball clubs. I'm looking for the Giants to have a big summer this year. No one is talking about them. I think they're a little short with pitching right now, but they have the front office to know how to get pitching.
I think everyone's better except the Diamondbacks. The loss of J.D. Martinez will hurt them, but if they're collectively hitting the ball like they're doing so far, I think they can make up for that difference. But again, now the Dodgers have to understand that they're the champs and they're going to get everyone's best fight within the division. I'm excited to see everybody, but I think the Rockies might give them some fits, and I think the Diamondbacks might give them some fits to challenge them.
Two things. Don't you think the Diamondbacks starting pitching is pretty good? I feel like I never hear anything about them. I mean, they're pretty sad.
To pitch there. You know, and Greinke, he's got to stay healthy. He's been having a little injury bug the last couple of seasons and been subpar. We want to see him be able to get out there and at least get 25 starts because he takes pressure off the rest of that rotation, but he's the key in that rotation for them.
Yeah, I mean, Zach Godley was quietly really, really good for them.
Well, they had a great year last year, but the only problem is they really didn't add anything to their team. And they subtracted a big bat.
Right.
And I was J.D. Martinez. I would have found a way to stay in Arizona.
Really? I wish he did,
too. The way the ball flies in that place.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, take a few million less, I would have stayed in Arizona.
Interesting.
Right.
But they still do have the core. I mean, they still have a very, very good team. But I see what you're saying.
Still got Paul Goldschmidt. He still got
MVP got a great team.
Caliber. They still got a bat in there. But I would have liked to see him be behind him to protect him. But he's not there. But they have the productivity to make up for it, I think.
Kyle Hendricks pitched in tonight, and he was great when they won the World Series. A notch down last year. He had a great spring. Looks like he's back. They go out and get Darvish. Lester, you kind of know he's going to be fine, right? They got your guy, Quintana, Frank. Mm-hmm. This Cubs rotation. We talked about their hitting yesterday. You love Chili Davis. Is the rotation upgraded? Are they in the right place to bring this team?
I think so. They got 6 great starters. I think they got 1 number one and 4 number twos.
Oh.
I think that can go and compete with anyone on a night-to-night basis throughout the season. I'm looking for the Cubs to have a big year. I mean, I'm a Sox man in Chicago. I hate to say
this because
they're going to take over again, but the bottom line is the Cubs is a dynamite team.
I love this rotation. They all pitch to contact. They have great tempo, which plays right into that athletic defense. Mm-hmm. They're going to get a lot of contact, a lot of swing and misses as well as far as this stuff. But I like the Cubs, and I got those guys representing the National League to go to the World Series as long as they stay healthy, especially in that rotation.
What do you think about the signing of Yu Darvish instead of keeping their own guy, Jake Arrieta, who they've been through the wars with, who was obviously excellent for them? They go and get Darvish, who, you know, has been a great pitcher. Last time we saw him, he gave it up twice in the World Series. What do you think about that move? And do you think it'll work?
I think they honestly saw some decline in Arrieta, and they didn't want to spend the money to keep a guy that was on his decline. Mm-hmm. They went and got another guy that has swing and miss stuff like Arrieta did when he was healthy and got him a little longer term. So I think they saw something in the decline of Arrieta and let him just part ways, especially a guy that's that talented. They must have saw something upstairs. But as far as getting Tyler Chatwood, a guy that pitches the contact and pitches better away from Coors Field, so it should work out. So I like this rotation a lot. I think it'll be fine.
Tyler Chatwood's
agent. I'm a fan.
He mentioned Tyler Chatwood five times last
week. I'm a fan. You just hating on him, that's all.
I don't know.
Hating on him. He had a 2 ERA away from Coors.
He might be the nicest guy in the world, but you mentioned him six times in 2 days.
I like the rotation. I get it.
I didn't like it at first because I think Arrieta deserved his money in Chicago.
Just because of what
he was been the number one guy the last 3 years. He was dynamite, won a Cy Young. But they did offer him $92 million for 4 years a couple years ago in spring training. Mm-hmm. He turned it down.
You're right.
I think that came back to haunt him because he ended up signing for $75 with a chance of making $125 million if number of things work out. But the guy's a dynamite pitcher. He'll do well. I'm not worried about it anymore because they brought in Yu Darvish, and I love watching Yu Darvish pitch. The guy has six pitches. You know, not many guys ever do that. But this guy, he's a special pitcher. He's got to stay healthy to take up the slack.
But, you know, your point, I know I'm busting your chops.
I like it.
His road split's fantastic away from Coors. And think about it. They spent money. He's their fifth starter.
That's another thing.
I mean, I know we're kidding.
The matchup. I mean, it takes a lot of pressure off him. Again, he's not the tipping scale of it. He's not going to be your big game starter. But, again, I like that rotation collectively with Lester and company.
Exactly.
So, against him, he's going to win a lot of ball games because that offense is going to score a lot for him. And, again, he's going to face guys like me. So, he's definitely going to get some run support. So, I think he's going to do well.
Tyler, listen. Just 2% to Dontrelle of that $40 million. He'll be real happy. He's already got a place in Coronado. Don't worry about it.